Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Daryl Anderson, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, from Angie Donna Fresco, from Corner Country Richard Paul, and Patty Doyle, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rivers.
Follow me.
Welcome, one and all.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
This lady is doing a show with Deborah Lee Scott, who was here a little while ago. It's called Angie, right?
Right.
Welcome back.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
She's playing Angie.
She's playing Angie.
Yes.
Now, this is this fella's first time on the show.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. No. That's right. Oh, no. No, but I just wanted to warn him that it's a show that requires an enormous amount of intellectual prowess.
Yeah, I'm here to attest to that.
And you're going to do just fine, because I hear they measured your IQ. Now let's meet our two players here, Artie Wilder and Jim Holzhauer. Artie very kindly asked how I was. Hit me in the stomach.
Oh.
Hard. Hit me hard. Harder.
Boy, you've been exercising, huh?
I have. I've been away for a week to one of them places where you...
Devil, you.
Oh. Jim, you didn't score any with your first-round question. Now we'll see how Artie does with her first-round question, which reads as follows. Ken said, the people who made that snowman must be athletes. It's the first time I ever saw a snowman wearing a blank. Ken said, the people who made the snowman must be athletes. First time I ever saw a snowman wearing a blank. All right, now help the new guy on the block.
I did. I just told him he could...
Hey, it's a round one question. They're wide open, Daryl. Do anything that comes into your little head.
Very good.
Ken said the people who made that snowman must be athletes. First time ever saw a snowman wearing a blank.
Tennis shoes.
Wearing a tennis shoe.
English was not one of my big subjects.
See, this group wanted something a little more basic, didn't they? It's not the most supportive answer in the world, but... Hello, Daryl.
Now I got it. Well, I was trying to think of something heavy or metal, and I said helmet.
A helmet. First time I saw a snowman wearing a helmet. They love you, Daryl.
I'm ready for you guys.
Okay.
Well, I started to say dance belt, but then I realized that you were not heavy into that.
No.
And then I thought about all the other choices, and I couldn't think of the one that they do in the, I'm not a big athletic person, so I said football helmet.
Well, that's two of those so far.
Never mind, Charles will have it.
Are you all right, Roger? Roger's putting the blue ink in his eyes. I have said on this show for years, it's time to get rid of Roger. I think now is the time.
Roger?
Roger is gone.
You're crazy. Roger, get up.
Ever since the marriage.
Get over here. Where's the Kleenex?
Roger.
Take it.
It's pathetic.
This guy.
Roger, you're a mess.
Now listen, what can we do for that?
I gotta clean it after the commercial break. I gotta go back.
He was so happy he could spell tennis.
Let's let him go now. I can keep everything in my head. He keeps track of some of the answers that they give in case I forget and how much money they want. So Roger,
all these years I'm getting some sympathy from you. Thank you.
Go to the nurse and then from there go to the personnel office and take your discharge slip and get the hell out of here.
The only way a cowboy could answer El Chaco.
El Chaco! Ken said the people who made that snowman must be athletes. First time I ever saw a snowman wearing a jockstrap. Okay? So we have Two of those and two helmets.
I think it's the only place in America you can get cheered for saying jock.
Yeah. I told you it was an earthy bunch out there. Yes.
There are other places, but we shouldn't go into it.
No.
I said a snow support.
snow support.
I get it.
Okay, so there we are at the end of round nothing and round nothing. That's it. Round nothing to nothing here, and round two coming up after this. Now, shall we carry on here? Go to round two. Ask Jim if he wants A or B.
A.
A. You sure?
Yes, sir.
All right. Okay, the great Zambini has the world's strangest circus act.
Yeah. How strange is it?
Yeah. And you're not even going to get a second chance either. Here's what he does. He climbs up an enormous tower and dives headfirst into a blank net. You thought about it, Jim?
Yes, sir.
All right, here we go with you. The great Zambini has the world's strangest circus act. Don't forget the word strange now. He climbs up an enormous tower and dives headfirst into a blank net.
Hairnet.
Hairnet. They love your answer, Jim. What'd you say?
Can I go to the nurse? I wrote on my hand.
Hairnet. Right, they're very fickle. Yes?
I thought of hairnet, but I thought there should be one dissenting voice, just in case he didn't get it. I said fish. Net. Fish net.
Fish net.
Fish net.
No, that's all right. No, it's
don't
okay.
Don't you know me now.
Now, fish net
I
is not bad.
I have connections in high places.
Yeah.
And they all look like this. Yes, dear?
The only thing a bald cowboy could write.
Hairnet. Partner, fight any man in his saloon who says you're bald, partner. Hello, Donna.
Hello.
Ready to go here?
Yep.
Okay.
Ready? Hairnet.
Hairnet.
Gutsy guy, but yep. His act was very popular, but short-lived.
Short-lived.
He was here today and gone tomorrow. Uh-huh. Sorry.
I like it.
Yeah. I hate it.
Since he pronounced short-lived correctly, people mostly incorrectly say short-lived instead of short-lived. Yes?
Hello.
Did you skip English 1, 2?
3, 4.
Here. Here. Okay. Ready to go to work on it? All right. You need 5 to tie and 6 to win. Fred said, something strange is going on here. I just had to stand in line to blank my wife.
Read that again. Something strange is going on.
Read it aloud. Fred said, something strange is going on here. Just had to stand in line to blank my wife. Okay. Here we go, Arden. Fred said, something strange is going on here. I just had to stand in line to blank my wife.
Talk to?
As we pointed out earlier, they were an earthy bunch. Something a little more basic is what they were looking for there. What do you say?
A little more basic.
Basic.
I said to phone my wife.
Phone my wife. Yes. Has nice teeth, doesn't
it? Has nice teeth.
Yeah.
4 eyes.
Probably no cavities at all.
What did she say?
She said talk to.
No, I didn't say that. I said kiss and hug and other marital stuff.
Okay. Okay. Come on down, Jim. Okay. I'm glad you won some money. Right over here in a little blue dot, if you would, please. There, stand there. I'll be there in a second now. Goodbye to Arda Wilner with $600, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. Ready? How do you feel?
I feel great.
Good. Here it is. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Pleasant blank.
Pleasant. Oh.
Now, if you match the answer they gave most often, you get $500. And for matching their second most popular answer, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. Three of the six ding-a-lings will give you some assistance here.
Charles.
Pleasant dreams.
Okay.
Patty.
Hello.
Wait a week.
Pleasant. What the hell is that? Say?
January.
Pleasant
journey.
Pleasant journey.
It's the American version of Bon Voyage.
I see. Thank you.
Brett.
Pleasant day.
Okay, so you have pleasant day, pleasant journey, and pleasant dreams.
Well, it was number three.
You choose one of those, or give us one of your own.
New York.
Pleasant Hills, Pennsylvania.
You want to review them again now? Pleasant dreams, pleasant journey, pleasant day are the three. Have you got a better one in your head? Well, then you have to choose one of those. Would you like to see him? Roger wrote them up on that cue card up there. See there? I mean, I look at them there.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You got them, right?
Pleasant day.
Now, Jim, these people, by their vocal demonstrations, this doesn't happen all the time, have indicated which of those three was the best answer, yeah, as they were given, you see.
Mm-hmm.
That was not the one. So, it'll be up there somewhere, I'm sure.
It better be.
I hope. May we see the $100 number, please?
Pleasant personality. That's
it's not going to be up there, I can tell you now. That. May we see the next one, please? The $250. Ah, oh, you got it. All right. Pleasant day. Now, what, in all fairness to the audience, what they wanted him to say was pleasant dreams, right? Yeah. But they already slide it. Pleasant dreams, there it is. Okay, now while they're hooting and hollering and cheering and you're figuring what you do next here, we got a little message for you right there. Okay. Here we are. Camera 5 has no tally light. Get that, Mark Breslow. Camera 5 has no tally light. How dare you bring a camera in here without a tally light?
Sue us.
Okay. Now listen, Jim, you've won the $250, means the least you'll play for is $2,500. Mm-hmm. Or if you get a lucky spin of the star wheel, you double that and play for $5,000. Step right up there and give it a spin. Good luck to you. We're all rooting for a double for Jim Holdsapple. Here we go. Go! Yes, sirree. Okay.
But it hasn't been on me for a couple of weeks, and I'm just a nervous wreck.
Well, you're going to be all right. Face me if you would, please, Jim. Okay, here it is. Good luck to you. $5,000 is what you're paying for. Blank wide. W-I-D-E. Blank wide. Blank wide. All right, don't say it yet. As soon as she's written her answer and put it in the slot, we'll call on you.
Oh!
Okay. Now, Jim, if you give us the answer that Brett's written on the card, we give you $5,000. $5,000. There we go.
World.
Worldwide. That's the right one. I hope she thought of it too. Okay, Brett.
He's perfect. He's right. I'm sorry. I said open wide.
Open wide. Yeah. All right, that's a good one, too. Open wide.
It was very good.
World wide. All kinds of good choices here. All right. Jim, you have $350 and a new player coming your way, Myra Millian here. Well, we welcome you. And before we start another game here, we'd like to find out where you're from. Any vital statistics you wish to contribute?
Yes, I'm originally from Havana, Cuba.
Yeah.
I am a travel agent and manager for a very successful travel agency in Encino, California. I have two beautiful boys, ages 2 and 4, and a great husband, and I'm here, and I'm so nervous.
You are.
Tu hablas? Como no, español.
Sí, brava, brava. Okay, here we go. You can have A or B. A or a B?
B.
B. Para linda mujer. Loose Linda. Oh, Loose Linda. Loose Linda is the loosest woman in the world. I'm having a heart attack. Last night she fell in love with an entire blank.
With an entire.
She fell in love with an entire blank.
Is my horse all right outside?
Yes. I gave him a bag of oats and I put the kitty litter where you told me to. Okay, Myra. Loose Linda is the loosest woman in the world. Last night she fell in love with an entire blank.
Football team.
Okay, Daryl. You getting a hang of it now?
Yeah, I said Army.
Army. See, maybe he knew her better than we did. Yes?
Daryl wants to know what they smoked before they came in here. Throw it away. I said calling on my own youth, an entire stag line.
Really? Don't lose faith, Myra. Sometimes you come up with those terrific answers the way you did, and the stars strike out there, as they do occasionally.
Strike out is an athletic term, isn't it?
That's right, yeah.
You're looking at a what?
At a terrific, powerful, muscular athlete.
Cowboy.
Oh, cowboy. Cowboy.
So in honor of the Dallas
Cowboys.
Cowboy cheerleaders.
Yes.
Hi, girls. Football team.
There it is. Okay, Donna.
Oh, well, I sort of matched Daryl anyway.
What'd you say?
Army base.
An army base, eh? Okay.
Such All a strange right. group out there today.
Yes, they are. Football team is the answer she's given us.
Well, I think it makes the girl like the huddles. Football team.
Okay, Mary, that's you. What are you offering? Fell in love with an entire...
American Legion convention.
And has never been heard from since. Oh. Yeah. Okay, there we are, 2-0. We'll come to you later. Now we've got this for you. There it is. The late Ted Terrific thought that he could do anything. He tried to cross the Pacific Ocean on blank. The late Ted Terrific. The late Ted Terrific thought he could do anything. He tried to...
Yeah.
He tried to cross the Pacific Ocean.
He's already given us the speed-up signal, Charles.
Here it is, Jim. The late Ted Terrific thought that he could do anything. He tried to cross the Pacific Ocean on blank. The late Ted Terrific.
Wings.
Wings. I guess Jim didn't quite understand it.
They're right. He blew it.
Yeah.
I said a skateboard.
Skateboard would be good. Yeah. Perfect answer.
Well, not so perfect.
Yes, it's a perfect answer.
Water ski.
Another perfect answer. More than one answer can be perfect.
Guess we got this one.
Another perfect answer. 2 water skis, 1 skateboard. 3 pairs of water skis, 1 skateboard.
And I think wings is a lot better than snowshoes.
Snowshoes would be very good.
This is the
3 water skis, 1 skateboard, 1 pair of snowshoes, a partridge in a pear tree, and now Patty Deutsch.
Drugs.
Drugs! Okay, that's all right. Join us next time. Match game 79. Gene Reagan here. Bye-bye.